Oh, this is separating. It looks gnarly. There we go. Do your macro photos look like this? Please. Stop. Like, seriously, please stop. I legitimately don't even know what I'm looking at. What did you take these photos at? F0.1?
Got it!
Today, I'm going to show you how to truly perfect your macro photos. And not in here, but instead, in here. And why yes. This video is sponsored by Intel and their new 11th gen Intel processor laptops. They sent me this new Dell XPS 13-inch laptop, and I gotta say, I am really pleased with it so far. First of all, we have to take some photos. Now, we've already filmed this in a previous video, so if you haven't seen that video and you need some guidance with the shooting portion of macro photography, the link for that video is in the top right and in the description box below. So make sure you watch that video first. So, long story short, you have to take many photos starting from the closest focus point of your subject to the furthest focus point on your subject, which will result in a series of photos at different focal planes. Now, the trick is to focus stack them to build one final macro photo, perfectly sharp and entirely in focus. On that video, there were a ton of comments asking how to focus stack, so that is what I'm showing you today. Now, this type of creative work is perfect for this laptop because the new Intel processor from their Evo platform, combined with the new Intel Xe Tiger Lake graphics, will allow me to build the stack and edit these images seamlessly. Now, some of you may already know this, but having a super strong processor and graphics card are two of the most important contributors when doing any heavy-duty creative work. They allow you to work faster and allow you to view more detailed graphics. All right, so let's get into the tutorial. And first, before we get started, I just want to say that this is my specific workflow. You may have a different method to your madness, and that's 100% okay. So, first, I import all my photos into Lightroom, and there's nothing special going on here except that I like to stay organized and put all my imports into a folder called Imports. Then I'll do an entire edit of one photo so it has the look that I want all the photos to have. And then I will go ahead and synchronize that edit to the entire stack of images. Now make sure you don't use the crop tool here. Keep all the images uncropped because we'll be doing that later on. First of all, really quick, what I'm noticing so far working on this laptop, it is a 13-inch laptop. I'm not usually working on laptops this small, but the Infinity Edge display is really awesome. It is a really immersive experience, and I'm not really negatively affected by the size. I'm really enjoying working on it so far. But anyways, export all the images as JPEGs and name them something appropriate with a numbered sequence. So for example, we're going to go with product_photo_ready_for_stacking. And it will automatically put this image in sequence by starting from number one and so on. I want to keep these images as high resolution as possible, so set your quality to 100 and make sure the limit file size button is unchecked. Last but not least, I like to choose a specific folder to save my images that are all ready for stacking. So I'll go up to the Export To dropdown, choose specific folder, and over here on the right, I'll choose my folder. For this, I'll actually make a new folder and I'm gonna call it Ready for Stacking. Then just go ahead and press export. For the actual magical portion of this tutorial and the program that actually stacks all of these photos together into one beautiful final macro image, I'm using a program called Helicon Focus. Now, you probably haven't heard of this application before, and that's because it pretty much only does one job, but it does that one job very well. It stacks all of these images together in one beautiful, final, sharp, crispy macro photo. Here's how it works. I have the paid version of Helicon Focus Lite, which was $30 for an annual license. If you do any sort of paid work that is macro photography, it's 100% worth the investment. $30 isn't a ton of money. That being said, you can download the free trial on your website to give it a go and maybe start with that. They aren't sponsoring this video. This is truly just the program I use to do this. When you open the program, click on the little plus button in the top left. This is where you import your photos into the program. Navigate to where your ready to stack photos are, highlight all of them,
and then click open. You'll see all the photos load up on the right panel called Source Images over here. Below that, you'll see a few settings which are probably a bit foreign to you, so I'm going to explain them now. First over here is the rendering method. Now this is essentially the method that the program uses to compile all of the images. So I'm not gonna go into a huge amount of detail to explain all of these different methods, but I will give you a simple explanation here and now. Now I usually use method A because most of the time my focus stacks are with very few images, so it's about 10 to 15 images I'm using. So they're not very complex. If I was doing a more complex focus stack, say 30, 50 images or more, then I would go ahead and use method C. In short, method A is for a stack with fewer images and about average detail. Increasing in complexity to method C, you're using way more photos for your focus stack, and they usually have more detail and more complex texture to work with. If you want to read more about the differences between the different focus stack methods, I'm not going to explain it now because it hurts my brain, but here is where you can read more about it. So if you click this little question mark over here, it'll take you to a very long, detailed article about all of the different rendering methods so you can decide what is best for your stack of images and have fun with that. We're not doing that now. Okay, so let's get into this rendering process. Now, the rendering processes can be pretty strenuous on any computer, but the new Tiger Lake graphics in this laptop should be able to handle it just fine, so let's put it to the test. The next two settings I'm gonna explain are radius and smoothing. By default, these are set to 8 and 4. Radius is the control that sets the analyzed area around each pixel to determine if that pixel is in focus or not. Now, smoothing is how the program combines all of these sharp areas of the image. If your smoothing is set to a lower number value, then there's going to be less smoothness over your image, so it will produce a sharper image, but that image may have a few artifacts in it. I would recommend to start with the default values and then kind of experiment as you go to see what works best with your particular image. Now that you feel you understand what all of these things mean and you're ready to see your final rendered image, go ahead and click render in the bottom right corner, and then you'll see the program do some fancy witchcraft looking stuff, and voila, your stack is done. Now the really cool part, if you move your cursor over the image, the program will show you which photo stack image it used for that particular part of the image it created. There's literally no reason for it, it's just kind of cool to know. Now when you're looking at your final image, if you notice any errors that aren't halos or weird artifacts that you could tweak by adjusting these settings, it's most likely an error that you made in taking the photos. So that's why it's super important that you take lots and lots of photos so that you have a complete stack to work with once you get into this program. It's really important that you don't undershoot for this type of thing. So assuming your stacked image looks good, you can go ahead and press the save icon in the bottom right and then choose where you want to save it. Now, my image has a few halos, so I'm going to edit those out within the program, so I'll show you how I do that. Select retouching up here in this menu and then choose a source image that you're going to use for your paintbrush. You could essentially just paint on the information that that image is using as a reference, so it's actually pretty cool. Now that I've finished this retouching in the program, I'm going to save it and then bring the stacked image into Photoshop for some last little retouching tweaks here and there. And now we're finally going to crop it. So once I stack all of these images, I find that the program has picked up on a lot of detail that my eye didn't catch when I was shooting the photo. So that's things like little pieces of dust, little fibers, just stuff that's gonna detract from how beautiful your final image is. So that's what I'm going to remove here. So to do that, I usually use the spot healing brush tool or the clone stamp tool, just really simple things to help me remove any of those distracting imperfections. Then if I want, I can make any final adjustments to light, color, I can crop it, rotate the image to my liking. And now, finally, we have a final image. The new Intel processor in this computer delivers up to 2.7 times faster performance for content creation. Now let's talk about what that means. I took these photos on my A7 R4, which has 61 megapixels. Then we went and stacked a whole bunch of those hefty photos together into one final image. So what this processor did was really speed up that rendering time for me to make that beautiful, magical final macro photo that we all took a look at. So let's take a minute to also appreciate that I'm running Lightroom, Helicon Focus, oh my gosh, what else? OBS, Photoshop, all at the same time, and this little 13-inch bundle is handling it just fine. It's 2.7 pounds, it's great for on the go, and above all else, look how freaking cute it is. Even though this tutorial may have seemed like a lot for you, this truly is only scratching the surface of macro photography. There are photographers out there who spend a whole lot of time focus stacking and even taking these images. What can they take, like up to a week?
Oh yeah.
A week to do these, and we just did this, and this whole process maybe took us, I don't know, about an hour, not including taking the photos start to finish, but just to perfect this the way we would like. So we are but a humble worshiper to those photography, macro photography gods out there. I'm gonna stop rambling now and hope that you guys enjoy taking some new macro photos, focus stacking in Helicon Focus. Big thanks to Intel for sponsoring today's video, and if you like this video, please give it a like down below, subscribe if you're not already, and make sure you hit the notification bell to get notified for all future videos. And I'll see you in the next one. I'm gonna finish my coffee. Has anyone noticed that it's just been getting lower throughout the video and you've never seen me consume it throughout? If you notice that, good for you. Bye.